afternoon, boys and girls. I hope you are doing well. I hope you are keeping safe. And I hope you are obeying your parents. And we have missed you here in church. But God is faithful. We are praying for you. And God is going to take away coronavirus. And then we come back to church. Now, our today's lesson, our theme is called Loved Children. You are loved children. You children, you are loved by God. And before we go on, let us pray first. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before you this afternoon with thanksgiving in our hearts, O God, thanking you, O my Father, for this opportunity, O my Father, to teach our children, O my Father. We thank you, and in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now, we are going to learn about how God loves us and if we can measure the love of God. I have a gadget here. It's a thermometer. I know you have been seeing this in the mall, supermarket, in restaurants. I know you know what it is used for. It is used for to measure our temperatures. But you cannot use this to measure God's love, because God's love is unmeasurable. And I also have this, is used by the carpenter to measure. You cannot even use this to measure the love of God, because the love of God is unmeasurable. And there is no love that is greater than the love of God. I'm going to tell you a story, which is from Luke chapter 11. Luke chapter 15, verse 11 to 24. It's about a father and his two sons. There was a father who had two sons, and he had so much wealth. The younger son one day came and told the father that he wants his share. The father gave him his share, and then he went to a very far away country. When he went there, he did not put up a business. He did nothing with the money. He just partied. He ate the money, and then the money finished. And when the money finished in that land, there was a famine. Do you know what a famine is? A famine is when there is no rain. When there is no rain, there is no food. So he became hungry, he had no food, and he went to look for a job. And the job he got was feeding pigs. He even longed to eat the food of the pigs. So he decided, I will go back to my father, because my father has got servants and they eat good food, and here I am eating bad food. So I'll go back to my father's house. So he went back to his father's house, and when he was coming back to his father's house, the father saw him coming from afar, and he was filled with compassion. Alisikia huruma vile aliona mtoto wake, because he was hungry. And he had no shoes, he had no nice clothes. So the father ran to meet his son. And he told the servants, bring a robe, we put on a ring and sandals. And he said that we must have a party for my son, because my son was lost and now he is found. Now you see the love of this father. This father is like our God. The father did not ask this son, where is the money? I gave you your share, go away. No, he did not remember all those bad things. Even you, when you wrong mom and dad, they don't chase you away from home. Maybe they punish you a little bit, but they still love you. That is how the love of God is, and that is how you are loved children. You are so loved by God. There is no love. It's an unmeasurable love. Let us sing a song. Jesus' love is very, very wonderful. Jesus' love is very, very wonderful. Jesus' love is very, very wonderful. So wonderful love. So wide that you can't get around it, so high you can't get over it. So low that you can't get under it. So wonderful love. That is the love of God. You cannot measure it. And our memory verse is going to come from the book of John, chapter 3, verse 1. And it says, how great is the love the Father has lavished on us, that we should be called the children of God. So, boys and girls, you tell mom and dad to read for you the story of the prodigal son at home, which is in Luke chapter 15, verse 11 to 24. Let us pray. Father, we thank you, Father, for this fire you have brought us, O God. We thank you, Father, even for our children who are at home, O my Father. We pray, my Father, that you may give us an opportunity, God, that we may come back to church, O God. And it is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.